Let's check back in with Chief Meteorologist Jeremy Nelson. You are here now. You're keeping an eye on when this heavy rain and heavy wind will leave our area.
Yeah, let's show you one area that's seen a little bit of improvement just within the last 10 to 15 minutes. So Hardeeville, you had a good gust of wind push through. These trees, the pines in the distance were shaking around. Now you just have a little bit of rain left over. The winds have eased up some. It's certainly still going to be a rather breezy slash windy evening. You have this severe thunderstorm warning for a small portion of Hampton County into Jasper and Beaufort County, but it's really this area right here that's going through Hilton Head Island, approaching Hunting and Paris Island. That's where the worst of the weather is, and that's the only tornado threat that's left across our area. That does extend down right here to Hilton Head Island, Harbortown area. But Chatham County, we've been lifted from the severe thunderstorm warning. This goes about another 14 minutes. Look at the wind gusts across the area. In the last hour, 41 here in Savannah, 53 in Beaufort. And these are not even the highest gusts that we've had today, especially in the Savannah area. So let's toss it over our team weather coverage to Catherine Liberta, who can talk a little bit more about some of those wind gusts today.
Well, Jeremy, I mean, we are seeing peak wind gusts today. We've seen about 54 mile an hour winds for Beaufort. Savannah got to about 51 earlier this afternoon. Alma and Fort Stewart just about 47 for Alma and 41 for Fort Stewart. Now, looking at the storm reports that we have had, well, we've had a ton of storm reports, whether that be wind gusts, but we also, I want to show you this storm report that we had just west of Alma. You can see a very lengthy description there, but there was the confirmation of a tornado path. The National Weather Service does expect about an EF1 tornado. With that, they're going to send out their crews and they're going to do a full assessment on that damage. But looking at some of the storm reports for our area, we saw the Savannah Airport, a wind gust 51 miles an hour. Now, I know Victoria is headed to that large tree that fell in a house, Montgomery Street. We've seen those very strong wind gusts, as well as power lines down across the area. And we have this one power line that was down right near US 80. So across the area, we are still getting those storm reports in. Jeremy, I'm going to toss it back over to you right now as you continue to track out this storm as it moves through our area.
Yeah, and we had that report now confirmed of a tornado that went from Coffee into Bacon County. And we were on the air here live on WJCL 22, providing you that information to help you and your family remain safe out ahead of that. Thankfully, so far, no injuries. Let's take another visual from the top of the Harbortown Lighthouse. Some rain right now, pretty steady, the gusty winds. You'll start to see the rain diminish as we go into this evening. It's still a breezy night. Winds relaxing a bit, maybe 10 to 20 miles per hour. Clearing skies overnight. A cool start out the door in the morning. We won't lose the wind altogether. It's cool tomorrow. Strong to severe thunderstorms. Oh, no. Here we go again. It's winter. Come on. Can we just get some tranquil weather conditions? Well, once again, we're monitoring impact day, and that would be on Friday. This weekend, though, does not look like those thunderstorms extend into there, just cool and dry. Let's take you through this evening. We hit about 70 degrees this afternoon. Now we're going to fall quickly tonight. Low to mid 40s out the door in the morning, and if you're well inland, even sprinkling in some upper 30s. Remember, though, there's still a brisk wind around, so it will feel even colder out the door tomorrow. Not a huge temperature recovery. We're in the low to mid 50s during the afternoon, right about 55 Savannah, Beaufort, and also Richmond Hill. How about the sky conditions tomorrow? A little bit of filtered sunshine out there. Pretty quiet conditions moving into Thursday. Remember, we're in advance of that impact day. Really no concerns. We'll see some clouds roll in, and then we'll have to watch this storm system. Almost looks like the maps we've been showing here recently, but the potential warm front could go north, and yet another cold front slams into that warmer, more humid air. So the 10-day forecast now, as we break it down for you day by day, there's that impact icon in there, around 70 degrees on Friday, the 50s this upcoming weekend. Some showery weather conditions are back with us as we go into next week, and then potentially one of the strongest cold fronts so far this season around next Wednesday. That could be sending nighttime lows inland down into the 20s. The 10-day numbers now, Hilton Head, Tybee Island, our coastal communities, islands and beaches. You're looking at 50s really the next couple days, and then that impact day coming up Friday with those colder conditions really spilling in here by the middle part of next week. You can track all the changes in the free WJCL 22 News app. Just stop by the Google Play or the Apple App Store.